So hi guys, today let's talk about how to study physiology for your exams and all, okay? So last time we discussed about anatomy. Now this is physiology. It is not going to be like anatomy because anatomy was a very learning subject. Physiology is very, very, very conceptual subject. So it's going to be totally different. So let's start with what is clinical physiology. So when I was studying physiology in my first year, then again, I used to think in physiology that this is the physiology, and when I study something, some physiology or some disease, then that is clinical physiology. Well, that actually is kind of pathophysiology, not clinical physiology. So what is missing here? So what should also be included in this scenario, that is that whatever system I'm studying, how do I assess that system in my patients? So how do you apply physiology in clinical? So first of all, you should know how to assess those systems, how to see those systems, see that physiology in your patients. What do I actually mean is that when a patient comes to you, means when you will be in the second year and your postings will start, when you see some patient, then you should be able to tell what is wrong with his physiology. Example, let's say a patient comes who has some respiratory problem. So you should be able to tell that the primary cause of his condition is because of some respiratory problem. And if it is a lung disease, then you should be able to tell whether it's an obstructive disease or a restrictive disease. That is a part of physiology. Now, let's say you say that it's a restrictive disease from your physiology knowledge. Now, what is the restrictive disease? What is the prognosis of the disease? What are the risk factors? What can be the complications? That all stuff comes under pathology and not physiology, but the basic should be in physiology. Similarly, one more example, if there is edema in the body, then you should be able to tell whether it's from some renal cause or from a cardiac cause. So whatever system you are studying, in physiology we study by the systems, right? So whatever system you are studying, then see that how do you assess that system in a patient? Like what things you will find in the history and what are the examinations related to it? So do that with the systems to understand the clinical physiology. One more thing, when we are talking about physiology, there is one more aspect of physiology which many people miss. In your medical career, right now the most important subject you study is medicine. The base of the medicine is 3 P's. It's physiology, pathology and pharmacology. And physiology is actually the toughest of the three. I solved many MCQs and let me tell you, from pathology, pharmacology, these subjects are still easier. When they start asking difficult questions from physiology, that actually is going to show you how much difficult questions in science can be. It's really, really difficult. You can do questions of anatomy, pathology, pharmacology, biochemistry, microbiology, all of the questions can be done. But physiology is something where even toppers fail. Studying physiology thoroughly is going to make a lot of difference in your rankings and all. Believe it or not, but physiology is actually the thing which differentiates an average doctor from someone who studied in Harvard University or in John Hopkins. Yeah. So now let's talk about how do you study physiology. So in physiology, we have theory and practical. We didn't have that in anatomy, but now we have separate theory and separate practical. So let's first talk about the theory. This is a highly conceptual subject. So the most important thing in physiology is going to be your lectures and your lecture notes. You won't be able to understand any book, any textbook, if you didn't carefully listen to your lectures. If you are not comfortable with the lectures of your university in some topics, like sometimes it happens, or you missed it, then rather than directly going to the books, get some lectures from somewhere. There are so many websites. I mean, on YouTube you will find a lot of stuff, but lectures are important in physiology. Then let's talk about books. Now, books for physiology is not going to be a very simple thing. Because, you know, it's difficult. The problem is that the gold standard book of physiology, that is Guyton, itself has a big problem, and that is, it is not that high yield. See, Guyton is a beautiful book. It's a well-respected book in the whole medical community. The problem is, it contains a lot of low yield stuff, which you don't need as a doctor. So there is another book, Costanzo, which is a bit concise and it's very high yielding stuff. So how do you differentiate between Costanzo and Guyton? See, if you are one of those students who loves to read, love reading books, have read novels, then Guyton is going to be your friend. It's a wonderful book for you. It's like a non-fiction literature. It's well respected, it's well written, and it's a beautifully written book. But again, the problem is it's too long. But if you like to read books, then it's a wonderful book for you. But if you're like me, who hardly reads any book and more interested in practical stuff, then Costanzo is a book for you. So these were the textbook. But well, Guyton can also be used as a good reference book. So you can have that online. The book I used as a reference book is this book. So this is Genong's. Okay, I don't know how you can read it, but it's Genong's. medical physiology, and it's a good reference book. The problem is it contains too much of stuff, okay? So I won't recommend it to be used as a textbook, but it's a good reference book. If you want some Indian author, then G.K. Pal and A.K. Jain are good books. But still remember, physiology is a very, very conceptual subject. What actually matters is your hard work and your thinking. The books are just there to help you. Nothing is going to replace your brain. Now let's talk about the practicals in physiology. In practicals, we have one is clinical. I told you about clinical practicals in the beginning of the video, and so do them system wise. Do practice those clinical practicals, as you will be using those practicals for the rest of your clinical years. So never ever take those practicals lightly. There's no way you do them theoretically and then you just go in on the exam day and do practicals in front of your teacher. You will have to practice it. Hemat practicals you will understand more easily when you do your pathology, but in physiology you will actually understand how to do those practicals. The pathology is just about the diagnosis, but in physiology you understand the mechanism of doing that practical, right? So then my favorite, the human practicals. So there are some weird practicals in which you have to do some weird things. They are wonderful practicals. One thing I will make clear, that a lot of people struggles with the viva of those practicals, and what is going to happen in viva, and people get too afraid from them. Let me tell you, in my experience, I have given many vivas in my whole life, I think. And any viva which is of your practicals, it is going to be only on what you have done. That's it. The teacher is not going to ask you what is there in the viva voice of the practicals in your practical manual. Teachers will only ask you what you have done. Do you know what you have done? Do you know what is the clinical significance of that? That's it. So if you want to ace your practical vivas, follow your theory textbooks. Again, I will repeat. If you want to learn the practicals, there is no better way than doing that practicals. It's like climbing mountain. How do you learn climbing mountain? By climbing mountain. How do you learn the physiology practicals? By doing them. So this was about practicals before your examination. Now, the real physiology will start after you are done with your exams. That means from second year. Because when you are going to see the patients, patients are going to present you with some signs and symptoms. And if you want to understand those signs and symptoms, you need to know your physiology, because with the physiology, you can understand what's wrong with them, because physiology is the one which is going to help you analyze how these system works. And also practice MCQs in physiology. You can skip MCQs for anatomy and biochemistry in your first year, but physiology should not be missed, because later on you're going to have pathology and pharmacology also. So better you do your physiology in your first year. So guys, this was how I study physiology and how I recommend people to study physiology. It's not the method, it's the outcome which is more important. And the outcome is that you should be able to use the knowledge you learn in your theory in your clinical. I also made a video on how to study anatomy. So if you didn't watch that video, please go watch it. If you really got something from this video, then don't forget to like, comment and share this video. And if you want more video about medical life, then don't forget to subscribe this channel.